Good morning, good morning. It is garage sale day, and I didn't have the time to take you around to individual sales on this day, but I am showing you what I got. It was a good haul. Actually, I did all this here in about an hour and a half, and we have got a full van load here on the driveway. I'm going to catalog it now. This year, I'm trying to streamline what I've been doing for over the years. I usually get way too much, which is in there, in the porch, in my shed, in the house. I am overrun with stuff. But you have to keep adding because it's like a wheel. You get the wheel going, and then once you get some momentum, then you start to make the income that you need. Anyway, long story short, we're going to get this stuff cataloged. We're not buying and then bearing and not getting stuff posted. We are getting everything posted that comes out of the van. It gets online, cleaned up. Now, there may be a couple of things that will have to get cleaned up over the weekend, but today, majority of the stuff here will be online and posted for sale. So there we have it. That is today's haul. I hope that you enjoy seeing what I've gotten here. It's not very entertaining because I didn't take you around with me. I'm sorry about that, but I'll give you a bit more information during this video to tell you what I did get, some of the fun I had with some people, a couple people asking me if I was Santa. One lady asked me, said, did I lose the help? Are there no elves? Who's making the toys? Who's making the gifts? I told them, well, you can tell times are hard when Santa's out here trying to recycle, reuse, and repost. Anyway, let's get at it. This was the Whitby Shores, the southern part of Whitby, their big community sale, which is great. It's like shooting ducks in a barrel. You just go around this tight-knit community and you get all of your buying done in a nice tight area. You're not wasting a lot of gas and time to do it. As you can see, the old sleigh is quite full. Now, I'm very excited because on my hunting list for this year, there's these Jim Shore pieces that I like, and I like the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. And I got my number one target, and I'm gonna show you that in a little bit. Now, I'm not going to bore you with showing you me logging the stuff, but I do want to show you some goodies. Sewing machines. The lady assured me that they work. We'll see. If they do, bonus. Two mirrors. They're at the side of the road. They have it's just coincidentally, they have the spring drive around pickup free sale where you can put stuff at the end of your driveway so other people can pick it up. And so I've been doing that today as well in a part of my buying in the garage sale. I don't have any space to put stuff, so I can't really take advantage of driving around the community. I could probably do two or three van loads today, which would greatly help me out for, yes, the roof. The media box there with some movies and whatnot, some movies that haven't even been opened yet. Everyone needs an Incredible Hulk hat. I did want to say something about the Hulk hat. I like the colors, so I am going to probably wear it. I had to buy it because there was a young guy. This was his first garage sale, and he and his mom and dad, you can tell they hadn't really done garage sales before because they were apologizing for the prices they put on stuff, and their prices were really good. And I was assuring them that their prices were great. They had nice stuff, but they said their son was so excited, he couldn't sleep. He got up around, I think it was 2 o'clock in the morning, and he was pricing his stuff, and he was just so excited. And he had some goodies there, and he had some stuff that I would have loved to have bought, but there were things that were gonna take a while to sell. But he had good prices on it. But I did buy his Hulk hat, and he said it was his first sale. He was totally excited. And I love seeing that entrepreneurial spirit in kids. So I wanted to do at least buy something from him. So he got money in his hand. And when it was only a buck, but he was so excited. He said to his mom, I sold it. I got my first dollar I made. And he wanted to take the sticker off. He wanted to know if I wanted a bag. The kid was awesome. And I had bought a couple of golf bags and some clubs from his mom. And he said, would you like a hand to your car, sir? Just a great kid, man. I just love seeing that. And kudos to those parents for doing a great job with their kid. He was awesome. I was glad I bought his hat. And now I was thinking, you know, am I going to wear it? Yeah, I'm going to wear it. Could I sell it? I sell it, yeah. But now, the problem is I get attached to these things. There's stories. This thing now has got a piece of my heart with it. I've got this Hulk hat forever. There with some movies and whatnot, some movies that haven't even been opened yet. But I picked the whole thing up for $5. But there was Schwarzenegger's Pumping Iron DVD in there. And that is good because that one I have sold before and it sells fast. Everybody loves Arnold. But down here, this is what I'm excited about. The Jim Shore Disney Showcase, Donald and Daisy Duck. Disney Showcase, Jim Shore, Eeyore, Life of the Party. Keep you waiting in suspense for the main event, the exciting, the main thing that was on my target list. To me, it's very exciting. And it's ironic because this is the first garage sale, official garage sale season. I did do a little one a couple weeks back, and I did do an Amish garage sale, which I may incorporate in this video, or I may do it on its own. I'm not sure. When we went to the Shady Maple. Don't forget to look at that Shady Maple video. That was great. What a buffet. I'm still excited about it. I can't wait to go again. It's almost like it's going to be necessary. I got the steak. All you can eat, ribeye steaks. And this apple cider, oh my gosh, the apple cider was so beautiful. Oh, I'm gonna have to show it to you. The Bumble from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. This is the number one piece from the Jim Shore collection that I wanted. And there it is, with Hermie and Rudolph on his belly. This is great. I'm very stoked about this. I've been hunting for this guy, and I've seen prices like $240. I've seen $80, $150, but never anything that I was willing to grab at until today. Guys, I got this and the other two pieces for $40. Oh, happy day. I am so excited. I absolutely love this. This made my day, and all the other stuff in there is just gravy. I got this first thing this morning. I probably got it around 6:15. I'm delighted. What can I say? So a little survey of what we got. Jogging stroller. Radio flyer. Parent push tricycle. We got one full set of clubs, two bags, a Callaway and a TaylorMade. Individual clubs. I got some putters and a TaylorMade Rescue, Callaway, and then this Rebel driver. That'll just go in with this set. Longboard. That's a cutting mat for doing sewing and arts and crafts. Size 11. Dukes, size 9, Bauer Supremes, two sewing machines, a couple coolers there. One is a classic metal one. Another one is a personal lunch cooler. Every construction guy needs one of those, and they usually sell those. The ball gloves, transfer chair, plethora of cages, good time of year. We all know what that is. My abominable snowman. A little nutcracker thing, my Ray-Bans, see, Ray-Ban, and some CDs, DVDs, my other two Jim Shore pieces, mirrors. Guys, that sums it up. That is the haul for today. I spent about $325, I'm guessing. Well, there we are, today's find, lots of goodies, and I could tell you roughly a price. But I'll tell you at the end of the video, after I get it all cataloged. I'll tell you what I expect to get for it. Good morning, good morning. It's now Sunday, and we're continuing yesterday's video because I did say that I wanted to give you a amount that I actually did spend, which was $302. And I've got a reasonable expected amount of return. In a perfect world, I would sell this all in 1 week and then I would start over next week. Unfortunately, it does not work that way. Some of these items may linger into the summer, but I did keep my numbers down. I bought a total of 39 items. There's about three or four that I'm going to keep, but the majority is stuff to resell. It's all the stuff of the things. I'm not gonna go over everything, but I did post up already the large mirror, the radio flyer, and a large dog cage. Earlier I did say three cages, I actually had four. I forgot about one more that I had there. So a realized rate of return for all this here would be roughly about $1,375 off of that purchase, because I did pick up some really good items that are desirable, we'll say, for reselling, and good profit margins. The first of the season, you always get the best because people are clearing out their garages. They're excited. They're turning a new leaf in their life, and they are making room. And so they're a little more free on what they're selling or giving up. May is always an excellent month for garage sales, and then it begins to dwindle down from there. By the time you hit August and September, she's pretty much over. There's still garage sales, but it's a lot of crap, and there's a lot of repeat. Some of the people are having their second and third and fourth garage sales of the season. Okay, Blue Jays, every video I do, there's something, whether it's downtown and it's those vacuums, or here, you've got the traffic going by, and now the Blue Jays, which are just noisy. Anyway, and I really can't emphasize as much as to how much I really can't emphasize how much that Bumble, the abominable snowman from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, the Jim Shore piece I got, how excited. I mean, I feel like I hit the lottery with that piece. I'm so excited. That really made my day. So it made yesterday a fantastic garage sale day. I'd love to take you around to show you some of the garage selling. Maybe we'll do that if we can get caught up here, but I have a list ahead of me that you couldn't imagine. I've got to stain the deck, set up a gazebo on the deck that we just bought. I've got to get a staining around the house done. I've just got a lot of stuff to do really fast. It's really difficult to say or to visualize or think, how could I possibly say I don't have any room in my garage? Hence why the stuff is still in my van from yesterday. I'm going to shame myself for your enjoyment and show you what I've got to deal with. Some of you OGs that have been hanging around my channel a bit, you will recognize the mayhem I'm dealing with. For those of you that have not had the pleasure of viewing my insanity, here it goes. I hope you're ready. I gotta get that spring tightened up. This is what happens when you just really need to get on top of buying and selling. And these are the woes that happen. There's a lot of misfits in here. There's a lot of stuff that was posted has fallen off. Isn't as saleable through someone's eyes as it was through my eyes. There's a lot of stuff dating back here, 6, 7, even possibly 10 years or more. Yes, there is something in here for everyone, but finding that everyone is getting harder, especially in this economy. This is what I've got issues here to deal with. There's going to be a lot of trips to Value Village, but I'm going to take a Friday, Saturday, Sunday and do a massive garage sale. When I see that weather coming, with that block of sunshine, that will be the day. And I'm gonna let you know to spread the news to anybody that's in Durham region. If they wanna see an epic garage sale, they can come by and witness insanity. Well, there it is, that's what I'm dealing with. Sombreros up here. It's actually even Cinco de Mayo day today. And I got the sombreros that I can't reach to celebrate, but that's okay. Let me turn off the lights. So now you know my problem that I've got to deal with. It's raining. So now you know what I'm dealing with. Weather, tons of crap of my own doing, housework on the outside, and still finding a way to create more income to pay for doing the work on the outside. Unfortunately, the gratuity end of things in the hospitality industry for bellmen and doormen have really taken a turn for the worse. We have gotten hammered, and there doesn't seem to be any reprieve in sight on how we're going to be able to make up that massive shortfall. And so that leaves us to A, find a new career, B, add an extra job or income, or C, just give up. Well, I'm not going to give up. I love the industry. I love the people. So I'm going to continue to try and work with my fellow team members in the industry. There's got to be some kind of verbiage that can be added in some way to help people understand that they're being given a service, or at least the opportunity to it. And, if not, it just fades away. It seems like we want to keep dumbing everything down to the cheapest possible, equation with Uber mentality, Walmart-itis. And then at some point down the future when it's all gone, somebody's going to come up with an idea and say, hey, service would be an amazing way to give you more value on your trip and your enjoyment. And then it'll all start all over again. But until then, I'm going to continue fighting to keep my head above water. Buying and selling, working at the career that I love and enjoy and have invested a lot of time. And at 55, you just can't start and pick up and start new again. I mean, I'm not Colonel Sanders here. I don't have a chicken recipe. So I am, though, as you all know, I am building my Santa business. So keep your eye open for Santa Sean stuff. Maybe in a corporation of both would be good. Maybe we should try that. Maybe we should just try in Santa going, doing garage sales, buying, selling, dealing with the same headaches and problems that you deal with. Santa has those issues too. Maybe that is what we're going to do. Who knows? Maybe I've just birthed a new thought. The world is my oyster. But for right now, I'm going to post a few more things. And then I have a cutoff today because I do need some rest because it's been a very stressful week. Birthday is over. I've accepted that I'm 55. I looked around. There's no Freedom 55. There's no sweepstakes coming to my door. Unfortunately, my lottery ticket did not win. I was in the running with millions of other people. So I'm going to continue doing buying and selling, trying to make you smile. I hope you enjoyed this video. Share it with your friends. Let's get my views up. If you have ideas and you want to see me doing stuff, I do have my YouTube channel, which I'm trying to get some direction to. If you have ideas for that too, I am more than willing to listen because I am all ears somewhere under here. And I'd love your ideas. I gotta go. I gotta get this day started. Enough of me talking to you. Have a wonderful day. I hope you enjoy this video. And it's not going to be near as long as all this stuff that I've been talking here. You wouldn't believe how long I've spent filming this video and how much stuff is going to be cut out of this. Maybe even what I'm talking about now. But then I'd have to add that in so you knew that I cut it out or didn't cut it out. Have a great day. Love you.